Not exciting. We were great.
The number one fan on the planet of Gennady Golovkin.
Rigondeaux.
You always been a Gennady Golovkin fan?
Who, me?
Yeah.
No, not really, actually.
Oh, now he's not his fan.
I've been a Canelo fan. Canelo. I've always been a Canelo fan.
Let me ask you guys. Canelo Kovalev, what's your prediction?
Canelo by stoppage.
I think Canelo's going to win that one.
He said by stoppage. What
by
round?
Stoppage. Well, okay, weight makes a huge difference. But if you really focus on Kovalev's last fight, he's been declining and pretty rapidly. And Kovalev's weak to the body from what it seems like. And Canelo's a monster at going to the body. He's going to stay in the pocket, break down Kovalev. Mark my words, if Kovalev doesn't have Canelo out of there in four rounds, it's done.
I can agree to that. Canelo's really good at slipping and dodging shots right in front of you, and he's definitely going to get to the body. Same thing that what happened to him when he fought, who was the last guy he fought?
Canelo?
No, not Canelo. Sorry, Kovalev.
Anthony Yard.
Yeah, he got hurt to the body there, but Yard couldn't put him out. I think Canelo has the skill. If he hurts him, he's definitely
going to Yard only had 14 fights going into the fight. Canelo and, has like 50 fights.
And if you notice, Kovalev in the later rounds, he starts wearing off. So I don't think his power will necessarily carry all the way through the end. So if he can't have Canelo out of there,
and knock out Yard in the end.
Yeah, but Yard and Canelo are two different. I know weight makes a difference, but
you have to respect Canelo for jumping up two weight classes and fighting a dangerous
absolutely
fight.
But that's always been Canelo's story. See, that's the thing with people bashing on Canelo. It always ticks me off, because if you look at his resume, name me a boxer right now other than Pacquiao in the top 10 that has a better resume than Canelo. You can't. Based on fighters they fought,
he does
fight
have a really good record.
He fought Mosley, he fought Mayweather.
Fought Lara when Lara was dangerous, alright? Fought Austin Trout when Austin Trout just beat Cotto. Well, Lara fight was good, but he took the challenge. It was a high risk, low reward fight. He didn't back down from it.
Somebody yelled here something. Somebody yelled here Triple G.
Oh, yeah.
He said Triple G has a better resume. Compare to resume. Who's a Triple G
fight? Triple G had a great run. But as far as the fighters they fought, Canelo has a much better resume. Yeah, name me, name six fighters Triple G you'll recognize prior to him becoming a champion.
Six fighters?
Six fighters he's fought that were pretty well known. There's a few, but come on, let's be honest. Given Canelo's track record and Triple G's.
Triple G fought David Lemieux.
Okay. David Lemieux, right? Okay. Old good fighters.
Willie Monroe Jr.
Come on, Willie Monroe Jr. At that time, I think
Dominic
he gained popularity
Quaid
from the. Okay. Come on, Ellie. You started.
Canelo twice?
But with the exception of Canelo. With the exception of Canelo.
Oh, the exception of Canelo.
Because we're comparing the two right now based on resumes. Within the exception of each other.
Who fought Vanes?
Vanes was a last minute step in. Come on. Those are like. If Vanes was jumped up a weight. All right, now compare that to Lara at Lara's prime. Compare that to Trout at Trout's prime. Mosley, not necessarily at his prime, but still, Mosley was a hell of a fighter. And jumping up in weight classes while doing that. He was 22 and he took on Mayweather. He lost, but come on, the guy's not afraid of anyone.
Hey, is Khabib here in the gym? Khabib stopped by today?